Everybody say, more than enough. God does not spoil life. Some of you are married. When you are poor, your wife, like my mother, grant Gary to train you. Once you see Naira, you go and look for Regina. You go and look for Emoyari. You go and look for Owokpa Mawawa and pack all of them in the house. Then your family who don't know God, they tell you, well, one child, if one woman had 20 children for you, it's one. What a foolish day. I've been privileged to eat with the highest presidents in the world. I've been privileged to go to 98 countries and preach. I don't know how people are able to manage with one and a half wife. One and a half. The one that I have, she's so strong that I'm praying God to still make her soft. One. I congratulate those of you who have 10 and you are still alive. Turn with me to the Bible. My darling, don't quarrel with me at home. I was just, okay, thank you. How many of you saw me apologize to her? Good. So, a woman, Mr. Allah, you hear this, it will thrill you. A major in the army, Major Ifansi, they came to welcome me yesterday. She got there and met a woman whose two children were coming from abroad. And they have been there for 3 hours trying to enter the arrival hall at the airport in Lagos. This major came and said, I'm Major Ifansi. And the police and the customer immigration, they allow him in. And the woman said, I'll be here for 3 days. My children are coming. So the major came out and said, Mama, come. So he told the police people, I said, I'm taking her in. She says she's come to receive her children and left his wife. The wife said, okay, when you come out, I will tell you are a major in the army and I'm the major of my house. So, guess what I did? I took the man and the woman to restaurant to buy them food. I say, I'm trying to settle your quarrel. I say, I beg you, Mama, you will win. Whether it's in the house or in the office, you will win. There's no need. Any man struggling with a wife is wasting time. If you want to live long, love your wife. If you don't want to have mark in your face, love your wife. If you don't want your tie to bend to a circular when you are going to New Benin, love your wife. That's all. If you don't want to eat poison outside, eat at home.
Well,
I don't normally do this one when I return from tour. I don't know what I'm doing this morning. But I just think families should unite. I think families should unite. Huh? Those of you that were trained by your wife, don't kick her out when you prosper. No. I was selling a bar at number 5 Ruby Street when I met this woman. The first money I had in my life, I bought her a bicycle. Hercules. About 6 months later, I bought my own. From Hercules to Raleigh. Today, we are blessed by God. I say we are blessed by God. Amen. The worst thing you can do to your life is to let family dictate your home. It's to let your position dictate your home. It's for you to climb up by a ladder and pull up the step that you use in climbing. You now say, my Naira, that's my power. If Naira become your power, you will not live too long. The only security in this world is God Almighty. I'm glad to be back home. John chapter 1, verse 22. Everybody give me your ears this morning. Then said they unto him, John, who art thou? Turn to your friend. Say, who are you? Turn to your wife. Everybody, say that. Who are you? I said, ask somebody, who are you? Yeah, we're listening to a message. Oh, why are you there? You're recording. Mowete, record this. Then said they unto him, John, who are you? So many people in this world today don't know whom they are. So many people don't know. When devil come to their marriage and to their family and to their finances and to their home to ask question, who are you? Many don't know how to answer. Who art thou that we may give an answer? Everybody say answer. If you discover whom you are, you will give an answer for people to give outside. Until you know who you are, you can't give people answer to their problem. You say you are a prophet with a heavy cross in your chest and in your back. It doesn't mean anything. We passed about 10 churches that I knew in Benin a few years ago, specialized in oracle on Sunday with white robes. Why? There's time for oracle in the church, and there's time for Bible in the church. And when Bible enter church, oracle get out. There's time in this town. 1953, you can't pass Iyaro at 5 p.m. The word was O-G-B-O-N-I, Ogboni. If you are not a member, you can't get job, you can't stay in the house, you pass that street, they kill you. Today, that is the worst, dirtiest story building in town. Ogboni in Iyaro, the building. It's the worst building. And by the grace of God, I'm going to buy it from Benin State government when they finally seize it. And turn it to a mechanic workshop. Say there's time for everything. People in this world have tried Owegbe. They didn't succeed. Oromila, they did. Anything made by man, not backed by God, will not last long. You need a security. You need protection. You need covering. You need shelter. You need a hiding place. And there's only one place. Having known the whole world, having traveled far and near, there's only one place secured, the blood of Jesus. Under the everlasting arm of Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Prophet from Yoruba land. Then a Benin chief got saved, who was a witch from Ovia. And he gave this Yoruba man all his jujus. I said, take the juju from me. I'm not going to become a Christian. The Yoruba man asked him very well. He's a man that died in Benin in 1957 as Oliwere. The prophet asked him, what was this one doing? He said, this one you used to vanish. What of this one? This one you used to conjure. What of this one? This one medicine for barrenness. What of this one? This is to blind people's eye from seeing you if you want to burgle their house. He asked the name of all the charms. He wrote all down. And the man surrendered all to him. What did he do? He said, I'm going to take them to Igboba River. Where did he take them to? Number 13 Lovely Street, New Benin. To make them his own idol under his bed, a prophet. A true story in Benin here. The man that died in 1957, Oliwere, was a prophet from Egba. He packed that man juju and took to the house and began to charge more to pray for people. And those power that left the other man descended on him. Jesus said, if you pick one demon out of somebody and you don't cover that house with the power of the blood of Jesus, seven demons stronger than the one you left will come. That man died in this town naked, hopeless, senseless, powerless in this town. There's only one place I know in the whole world where kings and judges and lawyers, politicians, poor, rich can go and hide and find safety. Only one place. When Owegbe came to this town, it was a political power or do or die. It rained and rained and rained and rained and rained and rained. Just as it's raining outside now, it will stop. How many of you know the rain will stop? Owegbe rain and rain and rain and stop. Owegbe died.
Ohwahe died. Azelu died. Ohogu, a pia of Ingun Street. Anthony was his first name. Pia. He can take cutlass and knock his head. No blood will come out. Use hammer on his head. I grew. Ephraim, you know him very well. Anthony of Ingun Street. No, yegogo bohun esagin eladia. Ohogu name. Today, he has no food to eat behind the stadium. No food to eat. There's only one power that I know from beginning, from day one to the last day that will never reduce, is the power of Jesus Christ. Action Group came to this town. Action Group. CNC came to this town. Obga came to this town. Everything you can name. Shagari came. Buhari came. Idi Agmo came. Go One came. Go on with One Nigeria. Anything I can name this morning, there was a time they were there. Today, they are no more there. But before you and I were born, and after we are gone, there's one thing that came before us, is still before us, shall be after us, and shall be forever. God. Everyone say God. That's whom I'm recommending to you today to hide under. You are looking for money, go to him. You are looking for children, go to him. Apostle Sagbele of Wire Road. He saw that his church was not bringing in more members. So he went to Yekurimo and brought a native doctor. And they gave him ukokogo and he put it at the altar. He said, anybody that come here, they will never know their way to go back. And he called for all the Aladura church in town, plus people from palace and different places. And they all went there. And he brought this native doctor to come and wear a white gown, as white as the one Jivo Jomo is wearing this morning. Then this man now began, the Aladura people began to sing, Segbele, Wire Road, before Sula Triangle. They began to drum. This papa got up, was huge and big, say, hallelujah. The native doctor said, hey, yo. On Sunday morning. Hallelujah. Everybody say, hey, yo. So, who is this one? He hired him to prosper his church. Today, that church flies, stand on the door on Sunday morning. He can't hear me. He can't hear me. He can't hear me. In no Samaria say ye eto. Oh, one no Samabo ekpe wo talk it go wa. You need a protection this morning. You need shelter this morning. You need covering this morning. These Jews, these men and women, they came to John and say, John, we have tried all we know. We are looking for answer. Everyone say answer. Say answer. We are looking for an answer. Are you like one of those people? Who are you? Who are you? We want an answer to take back. John said. Everybody say John said. Say it loud. Say very loud. Voice. Say, I'm the voice. Coletta, God is looking for a voice in everywhere we find ourselves. A chairman of a company that will not take advantage of laborers. A voice. Employer who will not take bribe from the employee. A voice. A bank manager who will not approve loan
with 15% before you pay the interest, a voice.
An accountant in a company who will not give you a receipt
and you pay a different amount, a voice. John said, I am the voice. I pray that you will be the voice of God. I say that you'll be the voice of God. In a rotten world, be a voice. In a sick world, be a voice. In a suffering world, be a voice. In NTA, be a voice. In BBSTB, be a voice. In Observer, be a voice. In local job, be a voice. Anywhere you find yourself, be the voice of righteousness, shouting against iniquity. People are going to time you. They are going to say you are going to die. But thank God, to live is Christ and to die is gain. When we serve God faithfully as a voice, when we serve God faithfully as ambassador and ambassadresses of God, when we serve God in humility and dedication, when we serve God with devotion and commitment, when the world twists and turns, we stand. When market fall, we rise. When everything we lean on lose power, the greater one still dwells in our hearts. 4 days ago, a man prophesied from political arena. He said, a day is coming. A day is coming. He said it 7 years before he died. He said, a day is coming. Man will be able to send man to moon and bring him back. He said it after 7 years he died. 7 years after he died, man went to moon and came back. That is how to fly. Wakinatin utin se. Head your hokona zezobo yada. Azerebona, uki orebona. Mama Zen. You don't have wizard in Nigeria, you have idiots. The witches that I know, they go to moon and come back. The witches that I know, they say, Umagba, are you going to London? What time? They put your name in one piece of tin. They say, yeah, that's how to fly. For you to be flying and eating your neighbor's children, Uguati Uzuo. Children can get scholarship because you fly. No. Show me a native doctor's son in this town that have a beautiful story building. Not one. Mama is not quite wanna know why you mose. Ero. Your maid will be talking forward. You are talking backward. If you are a man of my size and you have achieved nothing, is it when you become an owl, a sugusu, that you can do something? Show me any witch that in this town that put in the gate, revival, witchcraft. I'll send you Gia Bohon as an example. A very useful, intelligent young man is indoctrinating young men from university to practice witchcraft, and he can't make it. God will not permit a wizard to make it. Because God cannot contradict himself. And if something happened to you, say, I suffer broke of leg. My leg is broken. My head is cracked. It was caused by God. No. God doesn't cause accident because child abuse is an offense. Child abuse is an offense. You can be sued for abusing your children. And if God begins to break his children's head, he can go to court. It's an offense to abuse your children. And God will never do it. I want to ask you a question. What are you depending on? No, don't answer me. No, you can say God in the church. But when we get home, what am I waiting for? If we want Matinya, Ibnaka, Ibnaka, Ibn, Ibnovia, Ibnaho, Ibn, Ibnisago, if we want to walk with him, now you're bomb. Ibnogo Dua. That's the middle name of Abba of Benin. Solomon Ibnogo Dua Kenzwa. Not yet, Yawa. That's a good name. Was when I been a beer business, when I been a son, when I been no hood, when I been a Namaheke, I fear for somebody say, my new answer. There were no bow, son. Negwed Yavavan. Oh, one here, mana, anyone have. What's that? Upa la dia baby le. Salo dua mudia a boy de boto. Say we are men of underworld. If you're on top of the world, you can't make it. How will you make it under? I'd rather be a man of overworld, above the world, than to be underworld. Everybody say, above only.
Above.
Say it louder, above only.
Above.
Say from today, above only.
Above.
Say, God, lift me above only.
God, lift me above only.
John answered the question that many Christians cannot answer today. Who are thou? I am the voice. Where there's darkness, I'm the voice of light. Where there's hunger, I'm the voice of feeding. Where there's lack, I'm the voice of supply. Where there's sorrow and the voice of joy. Where there's defeat and the voice of victory. Where there's lack and the voice of supply. Where there's downcast and the voice of lipmen. Where there's nothing and the voice of something. And the voice of the Most High. I want to pray for you today that God will make you a voice. Stand up. I say, stand up. Join hand with somebody on your left and right. Ora baba baba mama robo bobo sekere. Kira la baba mama soko lobo. Pastor Robert, get ready with your team, for he lives in me and lives in you. After this prayer, join hand with somebody. Everybody join hand together. I have enough faith to believe God with you today. Now look at me, all silent, look at me. Maybe you have not been the voice of detect to your job. So the enemy took advantage of your ignorance and ruined your business. Don't let the voice of setback. Don't say to everybody, job is bad, business is bad. Change your mouth. Say, everybody around me, their own is bad, but God has given me light. Did you hear what I'm saying? If you have a child that is stubborn, don't curse the child. Don't call your children animals' name. Give them godly name. Let God help you repair them. Let God repair your marriage. Let God repair your home. Let God repair your life. The mama that died few days ago that these people came to bury was an intelligent woman. When there were only about 5 or 6 women in this town with money, she was one of them. She was one of them. The day I went to baptize her, I said, Mama, say after me, Jesus. She said, Jesus. I asked her, I said, Mama, what do you need in this life you have not got? Your children's children are living well and making it. You have one child. Your own daughter had 9 or 10. 10 plus others. I said, you had only one, but you got one child. That one got 10. And the 10 has now multiplied that you can't count them. I said, God has done you well. And all of you here this morning, God has done you well.
Yeah.
Whether you have car or you walked here, or you took taxi or you couldn't even pay for bicycle, God has done you well.
Yeah.
The fact that there's life in you, God is going to change the situation.
Yeah.
I say, God is going to change the situation.
Yeah.
I
strike you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lean on God. Stop counting of all sticks and trees. Stop counting on man-made gods. Count on the living God. Now I'm going to ask everybody right now who wants to say, Jesus, I need you more than before. Come to my life and repair it for me. Come to my business, repair it for me. Come to my marriage, repair it for me. Come to my home, repair it for me. Without shame, separate hand from somebody and come to the front here. If you want God to repair your life for you this morning, I want to pray for you before I pray for everybody. If there's somebody here this morning, and I know there are many of you who say, I've tried by the power of man-made power, but I want God to be my absolute trust from now. You want God to be your final power, come forward here quickly. You want me to pray for you to depend on God for your business, for your marriage, for your home, for your salvation. Come forward. No shame. Don't ask anybody questions. Don't think anybody is going to laugh at you. You want your business to change? You want your home to change? You want your children's life to change? Come out. Oh, you say I'm a visitor. That's why I'm asking you to come out. If you are ashamed of God in this world, if you are ashamed of it, oh, you belong to many things. The only good thing you don't belong to is God. You belong to trees. You belong to society. You belong to club. You belong to a butterfly club. You belong to stupid things. You need a bigger thing to belong to. There's something bigger than any other thing you belong to now, and that is God. That is God. That is God. That is God. I visited a king. I visited a king. Give me your ears while you are coming up. Push to that side. Push to that side. I visited a king in this country. All the people knelt down. Long live the king, you will never die. Long live the king, you will never die. I was standing. Then he introduced me to the crowd. After he introduced me to the crowd, I said, Your Majesty, may I say a word before I pray? Everybody look at me. I said, these people are telling you will never die. I said, you are Obaso so and so the second. Say, your father was first. You are dead. Your father died. You are going to die. These people are deceiving you to tell you, we woo, we woo me. Wa woo. Because I'm not here, dark not time when we're woo. Oh, nana. We're woo. What's that? Era woo. Not be ra woo. Not be only woo. Osa re dag mo no tan o to se o wo se oni ro nana abo wa lag mo na ti osa bo e go lag mo ti but the years you live in this world, may the good things in this world reach your hands. Did you hear my prayers? Say after me, everybody in this hall, say after me. Dear Father in heaven, I didn't hear you, say it loud. I give my life to you today. I've heard your words. I need to belong to you so that everything will be well with me. In my body, my soul, my spirit. I thank you that Jesus died for me. He rose again for me to live forever. Thank you, Lord. I surrender myself to you. From this day, I will serve God all the days of my life. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Now hold hand with somebody. Hold hand with somebody, left and right. Whether that person is big or small, hold hand with somebody. Hold hand with somebody. And I want to prophesy over you. Just as you are holding someone's hand, that's how God's hand is holding you right now. Amen. Maybe you have been standing alone in isolation. Standing alone without anybody to back you up. Standing alone in your home. Standing alone in your business. Standing alone in your marriage. Standing alone in everywhere you find yourself. Today, may God never again allow you to stand alone. Amen. I guarantee you, by the power that raised Jesus from the dead, there's somebody you cannot see whose hand is holding your hand now.
is the hand of God Almighty. And when that hand touch your hand, things change. Joy come in the place of sorrow. Miracle come in the place of confusion. Obstacles go for miracle to come. I know how you feel when you have no money in your pocket. As some of the people we grew here together this morning, we sold newspaper, we sold mango, we sold corn, we went to school with no school fees. First time I went to look for money to pay school fees, I was looking for snail and I caught big poor other. I carried him in my hand. I began to use hand to rub the head. The senior man in our team, here at Etete. He said, Benson Muyoto! I said, no, the thing is very cool, very heavy. He said, it's a snake, it can bite. I said, I know it's a snake. He said, put it down. I carried the thing like a little baby. Heavily, I put it on the floor. When I moved, that snake raised head up and jumped back. He said, you would have been dead a few minutes time if you didn't drop that thing. God was preserving me to preach the gospel. 1944, as a small boy, I carried a bottle of water to Orogodo River at Agbo. My father was cutting timber at Ababo. A lorry was trying to climb up the Agbo Hill. He couldn't climb. The motor boy put a wedge, the thing climbed, so I brought my leg to stop it. I said, what is this boy doing? He can't even stop it, so I brought my leg. A man who was a captain for Benin team, a few years later, jumped, snatched me, and threw me over the wooden bridge. He said, you want to die? I said, no. If this boy cannot put the wood to wedge it, my leg can hold it. You can imagine what a wedge cannot hold. A 7 years or 6 years old leg. I would have lost my leg out of concern for a lorry trying to climb. But God knew where I was going. At the age of 2, I was so sick, my father asked my mother to throw me away in this town. I was dumped to a garbage heap. My mother picked me back inside. If I tell you my story, you cry for me. But it's not a crying day, it's a happy day. Because if you don't know where you are coming from, you will not know where you are going. And if you know where you are going, you are not upset at where you are. You are happy, you know, because your tomorrow is going to be better than today. How many will say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
I say, how many will say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Coletta, when you know where you are going, you are not upset at where you are. Because where you are going is better than where you are coming from. I look at my life today. Address parliamentarians, address presidents, address prime ministers all over the world. Say something, government listening. Occasionally, they hear me. Once in a while, they ask questions. But I know where I'm coming from. And it was said, you can't be a preacher in this town. We serve God. We don't repent on time, but once we repent, we repent. Because that juju from Egypt still followed them till tomorrow. But this is the day to serve Almighty God. I said, this is the day to serve Almighty God. I don't know what you are trusting for your job. Somebody say you are now in a big post. You have to mark your head. Well, the day you begin to lean on your head, you are disappointed. December is coming now. You buy coconut to serve your head. It's not the head that did the job. It's God who gave you head. I pray this morning that in the face of all obstacles in the world, you one day say, God, I've tried everything. I want from today to make you my absolute trust. Your heart will change. Your life will change. Your home will change. Did you hear what I've said? Are you holding somebody's hand? Something good is on the way to your house. Thank you, Father. Oh, Rabba Mama Shikala Baradandolo Mama Hibabaraba Sekele Boria. Eternal Father, in the name of your holy child Jesus, I pray the prayer of faith for everyone that heard me today. I've challenged them to what you can do. You've done it for me. You've done it for nearly 2 billion people in the face of the earth who have confessed Jesus as their Lord and Savior, who turned from darkness to light, who turned from the life of tradition and custom to the life of God. I pray for every hand that is joined, that even in the midst of the joined hands, that the hand of God will join these hands. In the name of Jesus, I pray that whatever these hands find to do from today, it shall prosper. That God's name will be glorified. Thank you, eternal Father, for your taking shame from us, taking disgrace from us, taking sickness from us, taking diseases from us, and making us godly people today. We surrender ourselves as never before, asking you to have your way. Have your way in the morning, have your way in the afternoon, have your way in the night, have your way throughout all our life journey. Have your way and glorify yourself in our midst. And I thank you for it. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the Lord himself back you when you stand up. Back you when you lie down. Back you when you are confused. Back you when you are in trouble. Deliver you from the reach of the enemy. And surround you with his presence night and day to the praise and glory of his name. In the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, I pray and believe is done. In Jesus' name, amen. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Everybody say amen.
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 Confess it with your mouth. Believe it with your heart. Something good is going to happen to you.